very good morning to all of my students, all of the aspirants. Good morning to all the excellencies, distinguished guests, and my colleagues and my dear friends. Today, I would like to initiate something for all of the students and all of the candidates, those who are preparing for the various kind of examination. For that reason, I initiated this project for all of you. First of all, I want to tell you what is the importance of spoken English and communication skill, and why you must learn this spoken English skill and communication skill. So, in that particular skill, there are many components, there are many concepts, there are many ideas. So, I have to describe, also I have to discuss all of these things one by one. First of all, I want to tell you, number one, in spoken English, there is so many prospects, there is so many contents. First one is that, personal life. Second one is professional life. Third one is social life. Fourth one is spiritual life. Number fifth is financial life. There are so many aspects are there. There are so many parameters are there in spoken English. I am telling you what is the importance of spoken English, and if anybody want to develop such skills in their life, they need to learn English. Without having English, nobody can improvise or nobody can accelerate up their knowledge in spoken English. So all of you must understand these skills in spoken English. And in communication skill, there are some parameters. First parameter is that I have to write inside. Number one, in communication skill, the parameters of communication skill. The parameters of communication skills are, number one is negotiation skill. Number two, conflict management skill. Number three, leadership skill. And etc. There are so many parameters are there which is come under communication skill. So, my friend and all of my viewers, those who are watching right now, so I request you, these skills are very important. Without having or without knowing these such skills in your life, so you cannot make your communication skill better. So I request you, to all of you, from core of my heart, that you must understand this skill and harness this thing, then automatically your life will be transformed. First thing I want to tell you that before understanding all type of skill about spoken English and communication skill, first of all, I have to discuss that how our mind works properly and what is the nature of mind. First of all, whatever I acknowledge throughout a little span of my life, I want to tell you that our mind is divided into two parts. Our mind has been divided into two distinct features. First one is known as conscious mind, and the second one is called subconscious mind. Why I am telling you about the mind, what about the how our mind works? Do you know, most of the students, most of the aspirants, they do not have sufficient idea regarding the prospective, about the knowledge of conscious mind and subconscious mind. They don't have any idea. So first of all, we have to understand how our mind works properly. Then we have to come under, then we have to know something about the spoken emission communication skill. First of all, we have to develop how our mind works. And now I am going to discuss about the mind has been divided into conscious and subconscious way. And what is conscious mind and what is subconscious mind and what is the basic difference, basic and fundamental difference between two aspects. I am just going to discuss. Number one is that if you understand this thing, conscious mind and subconscious mind, I have to raise some question in front of you. Then you can better understand about this matter. First of all, I have to ask some questions that why is one person sad and another person happy? Number two, why is one person joyous and prosperous and another person poor and miserable? Poor and miserable. There are so many questions are there. I can write here at least 10 to 15 questions to make you understand about the basic and fundamental difference between conscious and subconscious mind. But I don't have sufficient time to make you understand in my one video. It is not possible to make you understand in one video. So I need a time, I need more videos to explain all of these matters. So I have written how many questions here? 2 questions. And I make you understand what is the basic difference between the conscious and subconscious mind. You know that most of the people, they feel that they are sad. Some of the persons feel that they are happy. Why? If I tell you these two concepts or two parameters, I want to tell you a story. Why most of the people feel or think that they are sad, and some why they feel that they are happy. The reason is that if I think that your mind is, suppose if I make you one computer here, suppose it's a computer, it is your conscious mind. It is your conscious mind. And whatever you store, suppose some file you store in the computer. Suppose it's a file. G file I have stored in my computer. And this file is known as or called subconscious mind. Try to understand what I am saying. What is the conscious mind? What is the nature of subconscious mind? Conscious mind is like a computer and subconscious mind like a your file. Most of the time we file, we important file we store in the computer. So in this way our subconscious mind act or work. How? You see that we have generate many thoughts in our life. Thought may be positive or negative. Thought may be positive or negative. So if you implement or utilize positive thought, if you implement or utilize positive thought, or if you generate positive thought in your conscious mind, then it can store it in your subconscious mind. And something miraculous, something miracle will happen in your life. If you generate or if you implement positive thoughts, positive thought means it is a file. It is a file. If you store it in subconscious mind, in the suppose you think some positive, something you positively you take a statement, and if you store it in your subconscious mind, then automatically your life will be transformed. there's something miracle happen with your life. So I request you, don't raise any negative point. Yes, negative thing will come in your life, but don't focus on this particular matter. Don't focus on negative things. If you focus on the negative things, it comes, firstly comes in your conscious mind, and slowly and gradually it will store in your subconscious mind and it will destruct you, it will collapse you. That means some people, they store in their subconscious mind that some negative things, they store in their subconscious mind. That means they feel they don't do anything in their life, they don't have ability to do anything in their life. They feel, that's why they feel they are sad. But if you store in your subconscious mind in positive things, then automatically some staggering powers will generate from your mind, and you can do extraordinary things in your life. So my friends, today I know more today, and next day I have to discuss so many things about this topic. Actually, in my very next video I will discuss about present indefinite tense, present continuous tense, present perfect tense, which is this. I have to discuss about tense portion, which is very essential for spoken English. From my very next video, I have to start this thing. Thank you.